Hey guys, did you miss that intro? Well, I'm more than done. Guys, this is Titan, and after so much time, I'm glad to be back. Today, I finally can release what I'm working on for the past months. And I couldn't be more excited. What you see here is a set of modular platforms, old and new, empty as well as already decorated with fitting props, and endless possibilities to make stations out of them. Well guys, okay. Now let me start this video with the maybe most important part of that video, namely the tutorial on which you how to place those platforms. There are two major ways to place and connect these platforms. That means one way to connect those for the ones with a path beneath and for the empty ones. When it's about the empty ones, you basically can connect them to your city with every way that you can think of. So for example, the usual pavement path coming from above, so maybe 10 meters and down on ground level, and if we connect that to our citizens, that's already enough. Just with this basic constructions, your people will be able to use this platform, and I can show you that just by connecting it to the main line. Of course there was a train. And doing it like that. And if we just wait a few seconds, the first people should go over the bridge onto the station. Now when it's about those stations that have stairs or an elevator or both, they have to be connected from beyond. Of course they could be also be connected from above, but they are supposed to be connected from under the stations. That's why I also included a small path, a small tunnel under them. And when you want to connect those, there were a few things you have to be aware of. The first thing is that in the middle of the platform there has to be a node. A node is each end and start of a segment. So when you drag something with move it or select it with move it, where the circle is, there is a node. And such a node has to be directly in the middle of a platform. Like that over there. Now we can bring it to the same height as the floor that is included. And when we connect that to the to the street level and connect it with train tracks, you'll see it actually works. Sadly, it's not possible to place these platforms without mods. So you can place them with mods, but you can't connect them with mods. And sadly, I can't do anything about it. And when we do it like that, people will go over this path to the station, to the platform. And I would recommend to use invisible pathways. Because it basically looks just better. Of course, you can't let it be like that. That looks rather ugly. But in the following cinematics, I'll give you some impressions on how it can look and how it can look if you do it right and in the correct way. Now, if you use multiple stations or multiple platforms, you either have to connect them all like that, or all like that. And like that meaning that under each of those platforms has to be a node like it is here. That may be a bit tricky, but that's the easiest way as I figured out. Now, of course, if you find other solutions how to connect them, or if you have other ways, if you have suggestions how it could also work, feel free to write them in the comments, be it on YouTube, be it on Steam, or feel free to write me on Twitter or wherever. I'm all open for other suggestions. And I think that's it. If you still have questions, feel free to ask them. I will answer them, of course. And if it turns out that it's still, not really understandable how it all works, I'll do another video. Kind of an in-depth tutorial. These stations are made after ones I often found in Germany. However, the design is generic enough to be used everywhere possible. Included in all those uploads of today are island platforms with and without roof, side platforms and terminus platforms with both old and new design. Next to that, in different workshop uploads there are also the same platforms as empty versions, for the like of you that want to detail it by themselves or want to use the platforms differently. Of course, I also uploaded the platform props with old and new design. To extend those platforms, I also made extensions for both platforms and roofs, old and modern, flat and terrain confirming. And as the last gimmick, I also included some props that can be used with procedural objects to have a custom, text on them. So for example, this station as of now is called Bahnhof, which means station in Germany. And if you want to have your own, station name basically, what you have to do is maybe look for a platform or whatever, and can also directly use for procedural objects, and all the here you can see all the props included in this set that are procedural objects. And if we use, for example, that one here and turn it into a procedural object, for now we just place it here. With the text customization tool, we can add our own text. And I also made the font DBWLS. This is the font you have to use, or, let's say you might use. Of course, it depends on you. So for modern signs, you might want to use the DBWLS font. For older signs, it's the DIN 1451 Mittelschrift. This is the font used by the older train company in Germany, so if you want to do an older sign, as I also presented in this video, for an older station, you have to use that font. Or, of course, you can use every font that's available for procedural objects. And another thing I included is when you use the DBWLS font and don't want to build a station sign, but maybe a sign that shows the passengers where were the platforms, or who has the tram or whatever. Then you can use the bold version of that font. And this doesn't have letters, but icons and signs. It has quite many of those signs. No, normal please. So I can write Ausgang, which means exit. And in another text field, I can use the bold version of that font and maybe capital B. What's capital B? That would be that arrow. Yeah, why not? Using that arrow, that means Ausgang, so exit to the right. And there's a whole bunch of icons I included in that font. For example, the little C would be the S sign for S-Bahn. D would be U for U-Bahn, so underground. F would be tram, or whatever. A would be normal train, and B would be replacement bus. Whatever, you have quite a lot of icons there. And when you look on the workshop page of these procedural objects and of these fonts, I included a sheet where you can see all the different icons I included and with which letter you can have them. So with all these assets and props, everything about stations should be possible. The ones I show you here are only examples of that, like a modern station, an old and overgrown station, sunken station, or just single platforms for suburban trains. The nice thing is that you can also use everything as fake station building, so let your own creativity and imagination guide you through your cities. On the technical side, I of course try to use as little tries as necessary and optimize them as much as possible. The probably heaviest single object would be the modern platform with roof, which without its last parts has slightly over 4000 tries, so it's all good in that area. And to save your city's resources, most of the objects use the exact same texture, so if you use the loading screen mod, it will take care of that and reduce needed RAM space quite a lot. Now in the end, I hope you liked this video and of course the assets themselves. So please leave a like and comment if you did so, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Liking the asset on Steam would help me a lot, and so I would really appreciate this. Also, a big thank you to my first 3 Patreons on Patreon who found the site before I even yelled it out to the public. Now if you're interested in more of my buildings, here on the right side you can switch to my last asset and a playlist with all of my assets. Make sure to also follow me on Twitter, over there I post some work in progress pictures and other stuff. And until then, see you in my next video, and bye bye.